I hope that you gave the, you obtained the idea that one should do all this work to get computational graph. But this, what we will have in the end? All those are numbers. All those are numbers. We just get a very simple linear graph to take dx and compute dy. Yes.
When I need to come to calculate the derivative of the function, like I want the derivative of a to the power of b compared to a compared to b, the inputs to a and b.
Yes.
Are the, do I use the dx1 and dx2, or use the original x1 and x2?
Good question. When you want to compute derivative of this function with respect to first or second argument, you need to know its arguments. You need to know W1 multiplied by X1. You need to know its inputs. And after you know its inputs, you get derivatives and put them here. And then, when you will move dx through the network, you will multiply dx by those numbers.
Oh, so
but compute those numbers, you need those arguments.
Okay, I get it. So I need to multiply by the derivative at the point. This is not an operator. It's just something to multiply with.
All the graph you will get in the end, it will be only some weights in the branches and summations. It will be an operator which you will get any argument as input and get something as output. And for computing gradients, actually we will back propagate through this like we told that compute gradients of entire error function, we will take gradient of external function and will propagate through this graph.
So if instead of dx I put a random vector, I get as the result multiplying this vector by the gradient. Or by
completely by Jacobian. If you put here a vector, you will product by Jacobian. If you will enter here the vector, you will multiply it by Jacobian transpose. And as we saw in expression of gradients, actually we need the product with we need the product with Jacobian transpose. So if we have chain function and this what we usually have in neural network, capital S will express the output of the network and phi will be the error function, sum of squares, for example, discrepancy between our output and the desired output. We will calculate gradient of this output function, which is very simple. And then we will multiply by Jacobian transpose. And Jacobian transpose is back propagate to our computational graph. Let's do the break at this point. You can stop the